My life, I've been fascinated by jungles. Stories about them and pictures of them have long captured my interest. And out of all of the jungles in the world, no place has ignited my imagination like the Amazon. The Amazon basin is endowed with one of the greatest rivers in the world, the Amazon. Along its 4,075 miles, over 1,100 tributaries drain into the massive river system. Far into the backwaters of these tributaries are some of the wildest places left on our planet. In a few parts of the Amazon, pristine wilderness can still be found. Unchanged for thousands of years, and unspoiled by the hand of man, as wild as it ever was, the jungle serenade carries on. From the river, mysterious sounds call behind a veil of green. Occasionally, the mystery is betrayed by movement. But even then, only the thinnest thread is unraveled from this tapestry of jungle life. Glimpses of fleeting beauty are but a taste of the things to come to the patient soul. For this is a place where time has no clock, only moments stacked together when opportunities arise and then fall back into the realm of improbability. These moments are guided by other timekeepers, the sun, the rain, and the sounds that seem to come from everywhere. Sounds that stand as evidence of the exuberance of life. It is this unrivaled variety of living things that makes the Amazon unlike any other place on this planet. Variation on a theme is taken to the uppermost limits, and I am humbled in the presence of all that is unknown to me. Birds look on like guardians of an emerald fortress. Massive trees draped with vines and straddled by epiphytes reach up towards the heavens. Who could resist the elegance of these jungle giants, these towering abodes, these highways of green? Under this canopy, secrets are revealed slowly and cautiously. One must earn the honor to witness the wonders of this realm, a price that is paid in the currency of sweat and patience, a price that few are prepared to pay. But I have lived for this moment, when kismet is finally at hand and dreams are realized. After countless hours of reading, the Amazon leaps from the pages of books and becomes a reality in the story of my life. Stepping into the jungle, I feel as though I am stepping into a dream. The lush green tropical plants create a luxurious vision of an emerald beyond. But these plants are more than the backdrop to an indescribable paradise. Locked within many of these plants are chemicals that may hold the keys to cure the world's most dreaded diseases. Many of these plants have chemical components that aid in holding off the onslaught of the greatest concentration of insects in the world. One of the weapons that are employed in this chemical warfare is the alkaloids. Alkaloids from jungle plants have already proven to be a source of very important medicines. The masters of this jungle pharmacopoeia are the shamans. These are the medicine men of the Amazon. Handed down from generation to generation, the shamans keep a vast knowledge of jungle medicine alive. I had the pleasure to meet one of these wise men of the forest. As I looked into his eyes, I was filled with questions. How many times those kind eyes looked on to desperate mothers as they plead for him to help a sick child? And how many times has he answered the call? How many times with rough but gentle hands has he carefully plucked the leaves of plants that led to cures for ailments that in modern medicine there is no counterpart? Only taking exactly what is needed from the forest, he is the model citizen of the world. Living a life dedicated to others, I am ashamed by the selfishness and greed of my world. His hardships are ignored as he travels through jungles that most people would never dare to enter, just to reach a person in need. And we call this culture primitive? We should all be so primitive as to put our needy and hurt, disabled and hungry at the top of our to-do list. For us, these acts of kindness are only carried out on special occasions. And on that rare occasion, we usually only do it as a spectacle, so that others might bestow praise in our direction. For this man, it is every day of his life, and only the jungle looks on to give witness to his acts of kindness. Plants all around, but where are the animals? Are they somewhere else, or are hundreds of concealed eyes peering at me from the shadows? Slowly, one by one, I begin to discover the forest voyeurs. The dark, soft eyes of a yellow-crowned brush-tail rat follow my every move. A lizard glances and then, unimpressed, returns his focus to a swarm of termites that swirl overhead. Even a wired-tailed manakin flies in to take a closer look. Folding back a small epiphyte reveals other tiny eyes. A poison dart frog peers out from his hanging hideaway. bright yellow signals to all would-be predators that the price for this meal could very well be death. Then something magical happens. Another poison dart frog appears. This arrival signals the beginning of the mating dance. Thrilled by the honor to witness the dance of the poison frogs, I then leave the forest gems to their privacy. High in a tree, a three-toed tree sloth hangs from a branch. Life in slow motion is the way of the sloth. A living collection of claws and fur, legs that don't run, and a head that never lays down to rest. A wonderful strangeness forms the surreal collage that we know as the sloth. This oddity of nature has made its way into Indian superstition. Some Indian tribes consider it bad luck for a pregnant woman to cast her eyes upon this lowly creature. They fear that this will cause the baby that is held in the mother's womb to inherit the attributes of the sloth. But when I look at the sloth, I see a beautiful creature. Its face seems to be frozen into a smile. Even its eyes look kind and innocent. This seemingly awkward creature is perfectly suited to deal with the challenges of its world. Long, sharp claws secure a grip while dangling from a trapeze of branches. Cryptic coloration and slow motion helps to conceal the sloth, for death can come on swift and silent wings. Sometimes the blessings of design fail, and one creature's loss is another creature's gain. For this is the way of the jungle. The hot sun beats down on the leaves, spreading a blanket of green-filtered light under the canopy. A passion flower advertises to pollinators in a flame of bright red glory. On the forest floor, an aquatic coral snake flattens itself into a defensive posture. With a display of color and song, a mixed flock of birds move through the jungle. Staying together helps to bring about the safety that comes with numbers. From the ground to the canopy, birds search for food as unlikely partners move in a wave of unified purpose. The beauty of diversity is made real as it materializes across a forest of dreams. Suddenly, frogs begin to sing the rain song. A jubilant chorus rings out in anticipation of the sky's gift to the jungle. At first, a few raindrops draw sparse circles in the tea-colored water. Slowly, momentum builds until the clouds empty over the forest, releasing a river from the sky. In all of its fierce glory, the rain delivers the power of renewal to the land of the green. Soon exhausted, clouds retreat, and for now the crying rain is pushed aside by the sun. Wet leaves drip the excess water to the earth below. Scruffy macaws wait for the sun to dry their regal feathers and return them to their former glory. Now that the jungle world is washed and clean, and all the thirst has been quenched, it is time for the hunters to hunt. Giant spiders come out of their lairs to evaluate the chances of getting a meal. A red-tailed boa coils in a display of attitude and power. Equal parts of fierceness and beauty, strung out on a frame of muscle, flexes a threat my way. Gaping jaws, ready to deliver a blow, promise to follow up in circles of deadly grasp. At the river's edge, birds scramble through the foliage. This is the last chance to glean a meal before the day ends. Again the frogs call, but this time they are calling on the cover of night's veil of darkness. The sun begins to lower its head over the green blanket of trees, and silhouettes are drawn against a pastel sky. Sunrise and the titi monkeys celebrate the arrival of a new day. A haunting yowl echoes over a prehistoric landscape. Slowly, the titi monkeys come out from the canopy to forage. Sweet faces peek out from the tangle of vines and green. A long, dangling tail hangs like a pendulum as a monkey pauses for a moment on a vine. How sweet it is to see creatures in the place that they really belong. Not in cages or behind walls of glass, where the most secret of animals are denied the dignity of privacy, but here in the jungle. Climbing, running on lianas, flying through the trees as they perform their elegant ballet of freedom. Other singers also add to the Amazon's morning symphony. The antpitta whistles in flute tones, a love song of longing. How strong must be the power of desire that a small, humble creature compromises its coat of concealment in exchange for a chance to attract a mate. Making a promise in music that its kind will go on into the future, and new generations will fill the jungle with song. No version of Eden is without the dreaded serpent, and the Amazon is no different. The anaconda winds its way into many nightmares. Its massive size and brute strength has earned it the reputation as a modern-day monster. But I don't see a monster before me. I see a beautiful creature that completes this magical world just by its very existence. For this is the stuff that legends are made of. The mighty anaconda lives somewhere between fantasy and reality. And after seeing the Amazon, I'm not sure where to draw the line. One of the biggest thrills came from one of the smallest creatures. The smallest monkey in the world, to be exact, the pygmy marmoset. As a child, I saw a drawing of a tiny monkey in the palm of a hand. This picture stayed with me and became embedded in my subconscious. I just could not believe that such an incredible animal shared this planet with us. Years later, there I stood, watching the object of my fascination. I took my time and slowly worked my way close enough to be able to see its little tongue lapping up sweet sap of the tree. Occasionally, the marmoset would stop and look at me. Moments like these are when dreams escape from the boundaries of sleep and enter into our lives. In leaving the jungle, I left a part of myself behind. I knew that I had been changed forever. In return, I took a piece of the Amazon with me. A piece that I will hold dear in my heart for as long as I live. And forever in my mind, I will remember the beauty of the jungle serenade.